Hi friend, this is Vikram and today I am going to tell how you can download and install IntelliJ IDEA into Windows machine. So you can just simply open any of the Google search like a search engine and simply type IntelliJ IDEA download. So you will get a very first link from the JetBrains. You will click on this one and you will redirect it to this page. So for normal purpose, what we are going to download is the community edition for the IntelliJ IDEA, because you can be able to see here we have the ultimate and we have the community. So we are using this community. What you have to do, you have to simply click download, and after downloading this one, you will be able to get one exe file. When you got that exe file, we have to simply double click on that one. It will get started and it will get installed. Once it is successfully installed, you will get one window to open or create a new project over there. So hopefully, if you are able to successfully install the IntelliJ IDEA and you are configuring the new project into your machine, so you will come to this window over here and you will not get any of this like the project over here. So what you have to do, you have to click on this file, new, and you have to select the project and give the specific name to that particular project. So before creating the project, my intention is to tell you how we are going to develop the scalar project into the IntelliJ IDEA using the SVT tool. So what you have to do, from a new project, you have to select on this scalar and then you have to select on this SVT. Then you need to click on this next. And you are seeing that it is checking the available SVT, available scalar versions currently. What you have to do, you have to give the project number name over here, like I can give the name as the create RDD. And you need to specify the location where you want to create the project or project. By default, the Java will be installed into your machine, so it will be detected. And make sure the Java is installed into your machine, because the scalar project is run and built and run on the top of the Java itself. From this SVT, you can select any of the latest version. Okay, there is no issue. But from this scalar, you don't always go for the latest and the updated version. So some of the scalar versions which is compatible with the particular version of the Spark, and that is already running fine. So I'll let you know the versions like 2.11.8 or 2.11.12. These are the two most successful versions as per my knowledge, and it is working fine in my case. So I'll be suggesting you that you need to create the 2.11.2. Then you need to click on this finish. Okay, in my case, I have created the same project already. So once the project is successfully created, it will take around a couple of the minutes to create this project over there. And very first thing, you will be able to see this build.svt. So just double click on this one, and here initially you will find the name, version and scalar version by which you have created the project. These are the two different dependencies, right, that I have added it for the Spark based application. It is nothing but it is a Spark core and a Spark SQL that I will be telling you why and where we are using these two. So once you have this SVT already done, if you are adding any of the dependency over here, you will get some refresh button over here, and if you click on that one, all the dependencies getting downloaded over here. Now there may be a question how you are going to add this dependency into your project from the online to this SVT. Simply open this one, any of the browser, and type over here. If you want to run with the Spark scalar application, we have this Spark scale Spark, and then we can write core. Spark core is the one of the feature, and type simply the Maven. It will give you the suggestion, Spark Core Maven dependency. Click on the very first link. You will see lot of the dependency which is available over here, right? So it is supporting for different formats. So what we can do, we can choose the one of the stable versions, not the preview and other things. You can choose either 2.4.6 or 2.4.5 and 2.4.4. In my case, I have taken this 2.4.4. Once you click on that one, here you will get the Maven, Gradle, and SVT. This SVT is nothing but the build tool for the Spark SQL application. You simply copy this one, okay, and paste over here. After that, here you will get the refresh button. You just click on that one. The dependency will be downloaded and it will be present into your machine. This is how we are going to add the dependency. So whenever we want a particular dependency, we can search it from the Google, and we will come to this Maven repository website, and from there we can either select the SVT or depends upon the work what you want to do. Like you can check the Maven also, but we are talking only with the SVT, and the dependency you can put over here and then update your project. So this is how we can create our own project. We can download IntelliJ IDEA, install into Windows, and how we can create the project. Till now I have not created any Scala application over here. This was only the setup video for the IntelliJ IDEA. Next time, in next video, I am going to tell how we can create the project, Scala project inside this one. So thanks for watching and stay tuned for my next